So a requirement we often get is what people want to do is they want to take a pivot table and then copy and paste it to use it in some other either pivot table or source, data source of some sorts. But the problem with that is you often have quite a bit to do. These gaps are a problem, these totals are a problem, etc. So there are two ways to effectively normalize data. Take data out of a pivot table so that you can use it elsewhere. So let's pretend we are only interested in pulling out the information for March. So what we could do, the first way to do this, it's a very simple way. We go to the one of these grand totals, and if we double click, what you'll see is it extracts just the items that make up that number. So if we go to the bill and you add it up, you'll see it comes to that number. So this is the one way to do it. Another way to do it is if you want to still keep this structure and you maybe want to do a copy like that, there's two problems here. First problem is that those gaps need to be filled in. Second problem is we don't want the totals. So first let's get rid of the subtotals. So in the field settings, I'm going to right click. I'm going to say field settings. I'm going to say I don't want any subtotals. So there we are ready a little bit closer. And now instead of manually going to fill this in, I can right click, field settings, under layout and print, you'll see repeat item labels. And when I say OK, you'll see it's now pulled it through so that we see every month on every line. And now if we wanted to, we could copy it and go to another source and perhaps paste as values or something like that. We have limited reworking to do here. Maybe you can get rid of the grand total. But even that here, what we could have done is we go to design, grand totals, and we just switch it off. So if you use a pivot table to get your data in the correct format, and we're only interested in March, you'll see it's quite quick and easy to set it up so that it's a very easy copy and paste.